not mean they tell us when the last 1% of the pipeline is ready to get fitted. That does not mean that they arrest hundreds of people, indigenous peoples, peoples of all color, before they bother to ask.
I would love to.
Free, prior, and informed consent is a rule of international law that would truly honor the sovereignty of the Standing Rock Sioux Nation. That snake does not represent our people. That snake does not represent our ancestors. That snake brings disease and death to our people. And then they wonder in the United Nations, why? Why will 90% of all indigenous languages in the United States disappear within 10 years? Why? We don't understand. Let's have another holiday. Maybe people will recognize themselves more. No, they're burying us. They're burying us in Mexico. They're burying us in Guatemala. They're burying us in Arizona. They're burying us in Canada. They're burying us in Alaska. They're burying us on the east, on the west, in the south, in the north, and right here. So today, as we give thanks to our Mother Earth, to our ancestors in this land, to our people all gathered here today, we demand that the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers stop this violation of the international and human and sacred rights of our indigenous people. My name is Marcos Aguilar Huitzilisli Huautzin, here on behalf of Anahuacalmecac and our Sociedad Semillas del Pueblo. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
that's what happens when you leave your heart open and your imagination is not crushed by colonized schools. Let's just say these individuals before you are not only decolonized, they're the seeds that we're counting on. We're the seeds. So pass the mic to Brother Shannon. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. The honor is really mine. Thank you. I'm going to pass it to Shannon. You guys don't go too far away.
How do I follow that? Relatives, I want you for a second to put your signs down and hold your fist up. Hold your fist up for Standing Rock. Look at your neighbor. Look at these people around you. There are very few of us who stand against oppression. Many of us continue to live in this society that oppresses our people. You have a choice today. When you go home, you have to decolonize. You have to make a stand for the water. You have to make these decisions that are difficult for people. Today, in this city, right now, there are thousands of homeless people. And there shouldn't be. We have enough food. We have enough water. We have enough land. We can grow our own food. We can tear down these dams. We don't have to rely on oil. We have plenty of sun. Today in Marrakesh, people are meeting about climate change. And these are people that believe they have power. John Trudell said, "We know what power is. They have an illusion of power." This is power. This is strength. I come from the deserts of Arizona, where thousands and thousands of people are trying to cross, and they die in the desert because of no water. Traditionally, we welcomed everyone. We honored them. We honored their differences. We honored their songs. We stood next to them. We sat by a fire. Today, we isolate ourselves from them. Today, many of us are at fault of isolating ourselves from the rest of the world. I am not an American. I am all of them. I am from the traditional territory of my people. I've asked these women, my sister, my niece, my Lakota relative, to stand by me. I've known her for several years. We do ceremony. We pray and we dance. For the water, for the plants, for the animals that live in the ocean. Relatives, we are stronger than this pipeline. Many of you have fear. Many of you I saw freaking out on Facebook about Donald Trump. We've seen 1,000 Trumps. He's nothing. He's one man. The power doesn't lie with one man or one government. It lies within you. But raise your hand and remember the power that you have, relative. Don't be afraid. Don't listen to the lies that they continually tell you. Pull your kids out of these Western thought process schools that continue to colonize your children and even colonize you. Relative, you have to decolonize the what you eat, the way you think, the way you see things,
the way you act, you have to decolonize so that we can live together. We want to live together. We want to live with you. But some of you are too destructive, and you can't live that way. We don't want you in the village. We want you removed from that village. But let's try today to come together as we have and stand with Standing Rock for all the women who have led that prayer, all the women who stand strong, all you women that are here. As warriors, we know the importance of our women, the importance of our children, the importance of seven generations to come. We know what that is. And relatives, today, don't think of next week. Don't think of next year. Don't think of 5 years. Think of generations to come. Remember that what we do today impacts those who are coming and those who are yet unborn. Relatives, be strong, raise your fist, raise those signs, and say no, no to this pipeline. Water is life, water is life, water is life,
water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life, water is life.
Thank you very much.
Knew then that the government was trying to extract resources and minerals then. So why or how do you think that he's still in jail when he was charged with aiding and abetting? He was never charged with murder. He's an innocent man. So we also have to tell Obama in the next 2 months to make sure that he is given his clemency and deserves to be with his family, as he has failing health. He has issues of diabetes, an aneurysm. He needs to be with his family. He needs to enjoy his children. He needs to enjoy the grass. He needs to enjoy the breeze. And he needs to enjoy the sun. So with that, I want you to call and maybe lock this number in your phone right now, 202-456-111, or say it with me, 202-456-1111, 202-456-1111. And that's the number to the White House, and they'll actually put you on hold for a minute, and someone lovely, a volunteer, and you thank them and tell them thank you. Make sure the president gets my message. So if you can't get through, that's a good reason, because it's actually busy. So keep trying and keep trying, okay? So with that, you can say no DAPL, free Leonard Peltier, and while you're at it, free Mumia Abdul-Jamal!
Oh, my Papiasin relatives! When I say Mini Wachone, you say Mini Wachone! Mini Wachone! Mini Wachone! Mini Wachone! Look at how powerful you are! I want you to just take that into your being for a second. Look at the power of all these people coming together. The people that are standing together in unity all across this country, all across this world, because this is a moral imperative. We do not have time to have more pipelines. We do not have time to build more fracking sites, more fossil fuel extractions. We don't have time as a species. And in here, this Army Corps of Engineers, they've been witnessing indigenous genocide, environmental racism. There's been no environmental impact statement for a pipeline affecting 17 million people, and no environmental statement. Where are you, President Obama? Where are you, Army Corps of Engineers? And when I was at Standing Rock recently, what I saw
was the most powerful display of love and forgiveness, meeting the most of human brutality. You're facing the wrong direction. You're facing the wrong direction. The police, militarized police. These people look like they're in Afghanistan. Really? Journalists, women, children, in peaceful prayer to protect their own water, being shot in the face with rubber bullets, dragged out of ceremony. They've been thrown into kennels like dogs, numbers written on their arms. They've had dogs sicked on them. They have had their ceremonies, their sweat lodges destroyed. And for what? For the greed of a foreign oil company. For what? When are we going to wake up, people? Look at the power we have. This pipeline represents 22 million new cars. We don't have time because we have only one planet. We have only one planet. We're looking at a possibility of 800 million climate refugees with only another 1 degree increase on the planet. We get no more pipelines, none. But guess what, every one of you, I want you to raise your hand if you have money in Wells Fargo, SBC, in Citibank. Raise your hand, am I the only one? I'm the only one that has money in? So right now there's a campaign called #BankExit. #BankExit. And I want you to raise your hand. My hand is raised, I want you to raise your hand. If you are committed now, in this moment, not only to show up, this is beautiful, but you get to vote with your money because you have. If you have money in HSBC, in Citibank, in Wells Fargo, in Chase, you are investing in the Dakota Access Pipeline and Bank of America. So I want to invite you, all of you, to stand with Susan Sarandon, stand with Dennis Kucinich, stand with Bill McKibben, stand with Shailene Woodley, stand with Mark Ruffalo, stand with all of these organizations, stand with the Native people, stand with Indigenous people. I want you to go in and take your money out. I want you to film it and tell them why. Tell them why. They will no longer invest our money so long as you're investing in the fossil fuel industry. As long as your money is in the Dakota Access Pipeline, we will no longer bank with you because we will not invest in Indigenous genocide, in environmental racism. We will no longer give money to climate change. We will not vote with our money. And I want you to film yourself doing it. Tell them why. Then invite three of your friends to do the same thing. Take your money, put it in a federal credit union. Put it in City National, Amalgamated Bank, Federal Credit Union. Invite three of your four, challenge them to do the same thing and post it to your social media with the #BankExit. What is the hashtag?
BankExit.
What is the hashtag?
BankExit.
God bless every one of you. We have to be willing to show them that it's not just us, it's all of our planet. 1%, 99%. We don't get more water. We don't get more land. These are all of our relatives. The one message that I saw over and over again at Standing Rock was that all people are relatives. All people on the planet, but some of our relatives, they're confused right now. And we have to understand, we have to come with love, we have to come with our power, we have to come with our forgiveness, but we also get to come with strength. And we get to sit and we get to vote with our money. So I want to thank my brothers and sisters today for allowing me the honor to speak. And I want to thank all of you for showing your voice, showing your power, banding together. All of you, all of the movements are uniting. Black Lives Matter was at Standing Rock. Veterans for Peace was at Standing Rock. The unions were at Standing Rock. These are all movements coming together. All people across the world.
In finishing the meeting, they're very much aware about the relationship with tribal nations. They have been cultivating that and they know how valuable that is. And it's up to us as First Nations people to reach out to all mankind. Because if you protect culture, you're going to protect the environment. The song I sang was about a water drop that gives life. Like our mothers that bring us into the world, we bring hope to them and their birthright. I'd like to share with you a little bit of this song that was given to them to be the conscience of making the right decision.
Okay. You can text him. Skyler's up there. He doesn't have a bullhorn, do you?
Alright. The sky or the heavens. Wishtoyo is the rainbow of all diversity of mankind. We come from different places, different color skin, different ways of life, different food. Let's learn from one another how to be better human beings. As we come into this world, and those of you that came across the ocean to be here and bury your dead on our land, let's work together for the right of humanity and for the right of our waters and our home and the place that we raise our children and live our lives.
Thank you. We're trying to shake this man's hand, shake their hands before we move, but we're still in circle here. At this time, we're gonna bring up a sister here that's willing to lend her voice, a very beautiful person whose work extends many, many years. And we want her for president next time around. So without further ado, I'd like to bring up to the mic Susan Sarandon.
Thank you. I'm honored to be here with all of you and with our brothers and sisters from who have stood for our water and are undergoing such horrible abuses. I don't know if you know that the United Nations just left Standing Rock and declared that it was inhumane circumstances there and have declared it an emergency. So it's taken the UN to go into this situation and say that people cannot be treated this way. Now, this past week has been very upsetting for some people after this election. People are depressed, people are angry. There are a lot of people that take them to the streets. I just want to say that we don't have the luxury of being depressed and angry at this time. This is a pressing issue. If only we had that many people that were aware of what's going on in Standing Rock and would be standing with our brothers and sisters to put an end to what is going on there. And you know, people called me and they were so upset about Trump and they said, you know, we're so afraid that there's going to be arrests of peaceful protesters and there's going to be they're going to be charged with felonies. And I said, do you not understand what's been going on for months at Standing Rock? This has been going on, and our other presidential candidate, except for Bernie Sanders and Jill Stein, have not spoken out. We haven't heard anything from Hillary. If you're a Hillary supporter, find out why she hasn't been talking. If we're so happy with Obama and with our progressives, ask him why he is not standing up for Standing Rock. He has said this will play itself out. We're waiting to see how it plays out, but the officials that are at Standing Rock, the cops that are at Standing Rock, are not playing. This is not a situation that is playing out. We need to call the White House. We need to divest. If you're in a bank and not a credit union, check out your bank, Citigroup, Chase. All of these banks are paying for the pipeline. So if you can't go to Standing Rock, make sure your money isn't going to Standing Rock and doing damage there. It's a pain in the ass to have to take your money out of a bank. There are clean banks. You can find ones that are not there. But it is more of a pain in the ass to lose your water, to lose your heritage. that we can't reach everybody, so pass the word. Divest from those banks. Call the president. Call, you know, bother the horrible governor of that state. You know, we have to put pressure on them because, unfortunately, what's right doesn't seem to be making a dent. The care for the future is not what they're concerned with because greed is so, so heavy right now. We have to look at where our money's going and make a change there. That's how we got South Africa to turn around. And, you know, we have to look at this now. It's not enough just to like tweets. It's not enough just to pass things on. A lot of people do not know what's going on in Standing Rock. And there's a reason for that, too, because we don't have major networks that are covering it. The Young Turks have been fabulous. UCorn Riot, Democracy Now, follow them. That what they're doing is hurting them as much as it's hurting these people. And I wonder at the fact that everyone has managed to stay nonviolent. That is the most beautiful thing that I've seen in a long time. And again, please just pass the word, even pass the word down the street, because I don't think they're able to hear that. But tell your friends, tell your family, you know, become active about this. This is how we will, this is one of the pressing issue right now. It's fine to be worried about the racism. It's fine to be, if you're a minority, to be worried about being shipped out. But in the meantime, this is actually happening. And so this has to be prioritized, and we have to do whatever we can. And this group and all the other groups that are gathering all over today in other parts of the United States, I've talked to Shailene, who's been working very hard and is a hero, and she's in D.C., and other people are all over. So thank you so much for coming, everybody, and keep up the good fight.
It's been an honor. Susan, real quick, snug in here, and then, you know, let's see a photo op. Before we march, before we get going, there's a few more things we need to do. We got a couple of buckets here, but we need everybody to pitch in.
Everybody can please make way.
Put something in the buckets that are going around.
Please make way. I used to have working.
So you can help out.
At the Renaissance.
And,
please
so
make way.
We're serious about this message.
Make way, please.
And
make way.
Danzantes.
Let's lay.
Thank you, bro. Everybody.
Watch your step. So this being a American Indian Movement SoCal co-sponsored event. At this time, it's only appropriate that we sing our song in honor of all our relatives and our ancestors that have fought and died so that we could be here today. And we want to live in their honor and create a better space, a better world for the seven generations to come. With that in mind, and with all the honoring that's going on, I'll sing our song. Yahweh, ha, Yahweh, ya, 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 ya,